So the funding that we've received through Big Lottery Reaching Communities has been hugely significant. We have been funded actually by Big Lottery Reaching Communities 2007 to 2012, and then through Support and Impact in 2012. But actually both Juicy Blitz Youth Involvement Project, the Young People's Juice and Smoothie Bar, and Bread Youth Project were at risk of closure due to a lack of future funding. So it's been hugely significant news. Obviously staff, young people and trustees really happy that Juicy Blitz can sustain in the work that it does in Lawrence Weston. Actually, if we hadn't have received the big lottery funding, then Juicy Blitz would have actually faced closure in August this year. And actually Bread Youth Project, in fact, in 2010, Bread Youth Project, because of the economic downturn, has seen a reduction in around 71% of its funding, and actually the organisation has had to rationalise its resources, going from four projects to one project. Wouldn't have had the resources to keep this the Young People's Juice and Smoothie Bar running, or to do the work that we do. So, and I think actually it was only after we received news that we'd received the funding that you realised the significance of that, and how involved in people's everyday lives that you are. Juicy Blitz has been it's a very small and intimate space where young people get involved in doing group work activities. We have a number of young people that have suffered bullying or a lack of confidence, as well as the other young people that are involved in antisocial behaviour and trouble with the police. And actually they would be very isolated somewhere like this. It's on the peripheral of the city. Public transport in Bristol is hugely expensive. It's one of the most expensive areas in the country. And there isn't facilities or accessible facilities for young people, either leisure or socially. The level of need, I having been a youth worker for 12 years, I was actually quite struck at the level of need in Lawrence Weston. In terms of child income deprivation, I mean it's really quite shocking actually in 2012 that some of the conditions and situations that some of the young people live in, and particularly in the first 2 years, emotional behaviour disorders were really apparent and actually disrupted quite a lot of the activities. But that's the nature of the work that we do, and by encouraging young people to get involved in the projects here and work within a small group of young people, they're developing those skills of working with others and their social skills. But actually a lot of them struggle to participate in that in the first 2 years, and we've seen quite a significant change.
Before I came to Bread, I was socially isolated, but now I'm more confident and I'm more interactive with the young people, and also other young people that I've known from school. At current, I'm in college awaiting apprenticeships to become available. After that, I'm aiming to go on to full-time business admin.
The best bit is the staff that work here, because they've helped me throughout the last 4.5 years with my schooling, keeping me out of trouble, my behaviour. I've really appreciated them doing everything for me. It's great for meeting new people, you meet new friends, stay out of trouble. They help you learn learn new things, skills, make you more confident. Before I started even coming here, I used to get in trouble with the police. I used to be hanging around on the streets. So basically, I reckon I wouldn't be sat here right now, I wouldn't be doing the things I'm doing right now. I'd be like, I don't even know what I'd be doing right now if this place wasn't here.